Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the anomalous behavior of that is beryllium, and now we're going to talk about that is what are the different uses of alkaline earth metals. So let us start with that. So now let us discuss about the few uses of the alkaline earth metals, and starting with the first point, that is the beryllium and copper alloy is basically used in preparation of high strength springs, and that is what it has been needed in machines. And there are various machines where basically a high strength spring are been required so as they could lift a heavy object and so as they could work on it. And that's the reason this alkaline earth metal, that is beryllium, has a good advantage. And let us talk about the next point, and that is the magnesium zinc alloy is used in aircraft construction. Because if you talk about the magnesium, and magnesium because it is belonging to the S block elements, and they are very lighter elements or lighter metals, and that's the reason that it can be combined with that of zinc, and also it can be combined with that of the other non-metals or other P block elements like aluminium, so as to form a very high strength alloy. And that is what it has been used in the aircraft, and the aircraft obviously they need a very light object as well as that should have a higher strength. So this is what it has been used. And now let us talk about the third point, and that is the magnesium hydroxide is used as an antacid. So magnesium hydroxide, basically known as milk of magnesium, that has been used as a sedative, and it has been used in antacid, or it is used as antacid, or we could call it as antacid. And so this was a biological importance, and it is very helpful for us in that is to control acidity. And let me talk about the other point, and that is magnesium carbonate is an ingredient of toothpaste. So even now in a daily basis it has been used, that is in toothpaste the ingredient that has been present, that is also consisting of that is magnesium carbonate. And now let us move on to the next point, and that is the calcium is used to remove the last traces of air from the vacuum tubes. So this is what we are going to talk about, the different uses of the alkaline earth metals. So let me talk about the calcium. So calcium is basically, it is reactive with that of oxygen, and whenever we have to create a vacuum tube or we have to create a vacuum chamber, so wherever a small amount of air is been located, so for that, so as to remove that trace of the air which consists of oxygen, we could use calcium. So that calcium will easily absorb the oxygen, or easily it will react with oxygen, and thereby we could find that is a vacuum is being created in the tube. So it is basically it is basically used to remove the traces of the oxygen. So similarly, even though barium reacts with oxygen at high temperature so as to remove the air from the vacuum tubes, so similarly to that of calcium, barium is also used so as to create a vacuum tube. And so to create a vacuum tube, because it's very easy, because we have to suck it, suck the air that is present in it, but still there would be some kind of traces of air that would consist of oxygen or nitrogen. So that could react it with other chemicals for which we are obtaining a vacuum tube. So therefore it would create a deflection in the readings or in the experiment. That's the reason that barium and calcium, they both are being used so as to remove those oxygen or those nitrogen that is present in the vacuum tube. And now let us move on to the last point, and that is basically barium sulfide is used to scan x-ray of human digestive system. Because barium sulfate is basically insoluble in water, and that's the reason it has been also used as that is we could say barium meal. So because since it is very insoluble in water, so that's the reason that it is used in x-ray machines so as to detect the digestive system, that is there any problem or not. So there were a few points regarding the alkaline earth metals. So this is what we have discussed in this point. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this topic very clearly, and I you will share this video with your friends too. So thank you, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.